Hello students, in this video we shall do some different, maybe little bit complex problems based on dimensional analysis. This is the last video on dimensional analysis and method. The question with me is, the air bubble formed by explosion inside water, okay? See, there is a water here and an explosion takes place and there is an air bubble and the air bubble performs an oscillation, okay, to and fro motion, right? With a time period is given as T, okay? Let us take the time period to be T, which it depends on. On what factors it depends on? It depends on pressure. It depends on pressure. Okay, we call the pressure here with the symbol small p. And then it depends on density. Okay, we can say either rho or you can say d, density. And then energy due to the explosion. Energy due to the explosion, we will call it as capital E. Now we need to derive a relationship between the time period of oscillation and the pressure, the density and the energy of the explosion. Okay, so let me do this problem step by step and see how we arrive at it. Yeah, we need to do it very carefully and slowly. We know that time period, what is the dimension for each quantity? Let us first take time period. Let me write in the other side so that we need not erase it on and off. Okay, yeah. We will take the time period T, that is capital T only. Next comes pressure. What is pressure? How do you define pressure? Pressure is force upon area. Force is ML T power minus 2 upon area is L square, L power 2. So power 2 and this you remove. Take this up, it will become ML power minus 1 T power minus 2. So we have pressure, the dimensional formula, m l power minus 1 and t power minus 2. See, we have to be very careful while taking the dimensional formula. If not, the dimensional equation will not come proper. So I have now removed, because this is the term is pressure, I done pressure. Now density, we know density is mass upon volume, okay? So we can take it as m L power minus 3, mass upon volume. And energy, we come to energy. Energy is equal to work done, which is equal to force into displacement, that is equal to m l t power minus 2 into distance is l, so m l power 2 t power minus 2. So this is that of the energy. So we will write here energy, the dimensional formula, m l power 2 t power minus 2. Once this part is completed, what we do, we remove this whole thing which we don't now require. We are going to solve the equation and dimensional formula, we are going to form it. Okay, let me erase it a little bit more neatly. Okay, yeah. Okay, now let us solve the problem. We know that dimensional equation, how do we form? The quantity time is proportional to pressure power x and density power y and energy power z. Okay, so you can take a, b, c also, but in order to change this, you know, I will put this z as something like this, because z and 2 is looking somewhat similar, so I am taking x, y, z like this, right? Now let us substitute the values, that means the dimensional formulas. M power what is not there, 0, L power 0, T power 1 is proportional to pressure. M L power minus 1, T power minus 2 power X, that is first part. Okay, now next one is density, M L power minus 3 power Y. Next energy, that is m l power 2 t power minus 2 power z. Okay, so these are the things, the dimensions which I have now substituted. Okay, let me erase it. Always do it slowly. Do not rush. Okay, then you may commit mistakes. So I have taken the values. So now that is next. Let me expand it. M power at x comes, L power minus x comes, T power minus 2x comes. Now again M power y comes, L power minus 3y comes, then M power z comes, and L power 2z comes, okay, and T power minus 2z. With that we completed. Now we will take the same terms together, that is proportional to M. Let us see M and M and M. M power x plus y plus z. It is over. Now L power 1 and here 2 and 3. L power minus x, L power minus 3y and L power plus 2z. Okay, keep this here. Now last we are with left with T. Okay, T power minus 2x. So nowhere and here minus 2z. Okay, so we have got it. Now let me take it here down just like this. N power t power 1 and M power 0, L power 0, T power minus 1. So now we have to just to make it equal to, okay, bring a constant k. Then only we can compare, right? If you don't have equal to mark, you can't compare just like that. Now I have brought a k here. So now I am taking x plus y plus z. Okay, because the board, now I need to erase it then and there. So let me do it like this. So let me erase these two steps now. Yeah, because I have got these things now. Okay, now let me erase this part now. Fine. Okay, now I will need x plus y plus z is equal to 0. X plus y plus z is equal to 0. Next, minus x minus 3y, minus x minus 3y plus 2z is equal to also 0. This is also 0. Last, you are having minus 2x minus 2z is equal to, take this value here, minus 1, minus 1. Once we have got all these things here, right, let me erase this part now. Okay, yeah. Once we have got equations, simultaneous equations, we have to now solve it. Yeah, we can call this as equation number 1, equation number 2. And let this be here, right? Bring this here down. X plus y plus z is equal to 0. Fine. So let me solve it. Minus x plus x goes off. So from here I get minus 2y plus 3z is equal to 0. I got an equation, minus 2y and plus 3z is equal to 0. So this is equation number 3, you can call it now. Okay, here also we can solve it. No, wait just a minute. Now we need to, this is having z and x and this is having y and z. Okay, this one part we have now solved it. Now we can take this and we can try to solve with this, or in either way we can substitute. 1 minute. What I will do here is x plus y plus z. Okay, so y plus z is there and is equal to 0. So we can cancel one more value and get an equation for this, right? So let me take here minus 2y plus 3z is equal to minus 2y. I think we should not cancel like this. We may get into a lot of problem. Okay, what I suppose is we should cancel y. Okay, by canceling y, we can do much better. Okay, I thought that because it is minus x and plus x is there, let me convert it now. Multiply by 3. Okay, so this will become 3y, 3x, 3y and 3z. Okay, because canceling this y will be better for us. Okay, so minus 3y plus 3y gets cancelled. So I have 2x, okay, 2x plus 5z, no need to change the sign because they got cancelled, is equal to 0. So bring it here now. That is 2x plus 5z is equal to 0. Okay, now this can be cancelled. Okay, now because I have not changed the sign, so 3z is equal to minus 1. 3z is equal to minus 1. That is, z is equal to minus 1 upon 3. So we got one value. Okay, so let me just keep the value safely, right? In one place, let me write it. Z is equal to minus 1 by 3. Let me put it in the box. Okay, once I got this, now in this I can substitute 2x plus phi of z is how much? Minus 1 by 3, which is equal to 0. So 2x minus 5 by 3 is equal to 0. That is, 2x is equal to 5 by 3. Okay, so which implies x is equal to 5 by 3 is there. Bring this 2, 2 3s are 6. Okay, I got this value. So x is equal to 5 divided by 6. I got another value, right? X value I got z value. Now let me check, cross check it, whether I have done any mistake in the sign or something. Let us cross check it little bit, and then we'll be very safe with that. X plus y plus z is equal to 0. X minus 3y plus 2z is equal to 0. 3x plus 3y plus 3z is equal to 0. 2x plus 5z is equal to 0. 2x into 5 into minus 1 by 3 is 0. 2x, okay, let me cross check it one more time here. I have not changed the sign here, minus here, and the 3z is as it is, minus 1, minus 1 by 3, I got this. Next I come here, I substituted 5 by 6, that also is over. Last, we need to calculate only y value, okay, yeah. Yeah, let me see what is the y value. Okay, x is how much? 5 by 6 plus y is how much? We have to calculate. Minus z is how much? 1 by 3 is equal to 0. Okay, that is y plus 5 by 6 minus 1 by 3 is equal to 0. That is y plus common denominator 6, 5 minus into 2 times it will go, right? That is equal to 0. That is y is 3 by 6. Okay, y plus 3 by 6 is equal to 0. That is 1 by 2. Okay, y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, so this is the next value, that y is equal to minus 1 by 2. Okay, so I got now these values with me. Okay, so I got all these values with me. I am going to merely substitute them in this equation. Okay, let us watch carefully. Now T is proportional to P, pressure power. X is how much? 5 by 6. So we will keep it 5 by 6. And D, density, power Y. Y value is minus 1 by 2. And E, energy, Z. E power minus 1 by 3. Okay, so these are the values we have got. You don't need to touch anything. Constant is not there. Simply you can write like this and leave it, and that is the end of the problem. I have a doubt. Maybe I might have done somewhere the sign problem. Okay, you just cross check it. Maybe if I missed somewhere, plus minus I put wrongly, you correct it. Yeah, I saw somewhere it is minus 5 by 6. Plus 1 by 2 and plus 1 by 3. I don't remember. Yeah, on spot I am doing this. So cross check it one time. If I made any mistake in the sign, then write it in the inbox. Okay, just write it in the inbox. This we will leave it as it is, right? We will leave this problem now as it is. Now we go for one more problem. Okay, so this is equally important. I want you to understand the concept of it. Okay. This is the second problem. Why? I want to tell you one thing. In the chapter units and measurement, please do not spend too much of time in measurement, error analysis, plus or minus, all these things. I want to tell you, these are all very, 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 very small part. The real essential physics is something you go deeper and deeper. Right, now you come to one-dimensional motion, two-dimensional motion, three-dimensional motion, then you have a force, you have loss of motion, energy, then you further move, circular motion, rotational motion, okay, system of rigid bodies, then gravitation. These are beautiful physics, okay? But when you start with simply the first chapter about scientists and all, and then about measurement, if you get stuck there, you know, you will feel science, physics being a boring subject. Physics is not a boring subject. It's a very interesting subject. It's a very, 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 very cerebral work. You know, you need to think, you know, that's a wonderful way you can learn. So that is good for you because that will help you in learning mathematics also well, and it will sharpen your brain so you can easily memorize things in chemistry also, use logical reasoning. So please, dear students, do not get stuck in that error analysis and all this, you know. I don't do all these things in the starting point. What I want to do is I want to inspire you. I want you to just initiate the process of learning physics as I did as a boy of 11th and 12th standard. You also should love physics. You should enjoy physics, and then we should proceed with the subject. Okay. So small, small things you can learn later also, that does not matter. Okay. You should enjoy the subject. The joy of learning physics is very, very, very important. Okay. Now, the question is, the frequency of vibration of a stretched string. It comes in sound, okay? You have a stretched string like a violin, guitar, a sitar or veena. The stretched string is there, you just pluck it, pung, yeah, a ting, that sound is coming. So he says that the frequency, again you see very carefully, frequency. Frequency is F, we can say, in this problem they have given N. What is frequency? Frequency reciprocal of time period. So we will write here, that is 1 upon t, which should be written as t power minus 1. Okay, that is the dimensional formula. Okay, and it is length of the string. Okay, let me write here for you. Length of the string, L they have given. So L only as it is, we leave it. Next is very, very, very important. Mass per unit length. Listen to me carefully here. Mass per unit length. But here they have given as only symbol M. If you say only mass, it is mass. But you have to consider mass per unit length divided by length. So L power minus 1. Dear student, do not make this mistake. You just read the what is the sentence given to you. Use that and you will be able to solve it. And then they are given tension in the string. Okay, tension in the string, that is T. What is tension? Tension, I have so much tension. Huh? There is so much pressure is there. So much force is there. Not pressure, sorry. So much. See, in physics, tension means you stretch something and that is called tension. And that is nothing but force. Force is nothing but ML T power minus 2. Yes. So with this, I got this formula problem. I place it in one side and I am trying to solve the problem now. First, let us form the equation, right? Frequency depends on frequency T power minus 1 depends on what factors? M power 0, L power 0. Automatically you bring it, right? Is proportional to length of the string. Okay, first let me form the equation. Let me not hurry. Frequency is proportional to length power A, then mass per unit length, but the thing they have given is M power B, and then T power C. Now I have taken A, B, C. Okay, so this is the frequency T power minus 1. M power 0, L power 0, and is proportional to L power A. Yes, let me remove this. Yeah. And M, here what is M? You see, M, L power minus 1 power B. Right. And then tension, M, L, T power minus 2 power C. Yes. Once we have done this part of it, we erase all these things and then we move on to solve the problem. Okay, so proportional to L power A, M power B, L power minus B, M power C, C, L power C, T power minus 2C. Fine. So now we bring all the factors together. M, M power B plus C. Yes, M power B plus C is over. So L power A minus B plus C over. Next we have got T power minus 2C over. All the factors have come in. So here you have M power 0, L power 0, T power minus 1. M power 0, L power 0, T power minus 1. Just we need to put equal to bring a constant K. Yeah. So I assume it you have done it. M power. So that means B plus C is equal to 0. Next. A minus B plus C is also equal to 0. Next. Minus 2C is equal to, you see here, minus 1. Now we need to solve this. Okay. So B plus C, let me not touch anything here. C is equal to minus, or minus minus goes. Okay. 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2. So C value, I got it. Bring the C here. B plus 1 upon 2 is equal to 0. So B is equal to minus 1 upon 2. B is equal to minus 1 upon 2. Yes, I got now A minus of minus, that is plus half, right? Minus of minus, I substituted, plus half is equal to 0. That is A plus 1 is equal to 0, which implies A is equal to 1. I hope you understand. A is 1. Let me cross check it. A minus B is minus half. So minus of minus plus half. Right. I'm right. Now, A is 1. So let me substitute in the next equation. Okay. The next equation we will solve. Watch carefully here. N is proportional to L power A is 1. M power B, that is M power minus half, then C, T power half, that is plus half. Okay, so we can erase this part also. Okay, now we have completed this part, we have taken the values. Now look here, N is proportional to simply L. Now T power half divided by M power half. Can I write? Minus half comes down. Okay. That is proportional to L. T power half is nothing but root to T upon root M. this is proportional to L whole root T upon M. This is the formula for sorry. Yeah. N is proportional to L root T upon M. See, here you bring a constant K. The K value will be calculated using the instrument, and using that experimental verification, we will get the value. So, what are all the limitations of dimensional analysis? It cannot find the constants. It cannot use more than 3 physical quantities. And it cannot use any of the trigonometric or any, what you will say, exponential functions and all, it cannot use. This is a side of a puzzle. You can imagine, it's just like a crossword. Yeah, you should enjoy the process of doing these problems. Plenty of problems are available in the internet. You can pick up them. Again, I repeat to you, do not go into small, silly problems. Try to do something broader area. And then you can repeat it back. When you come back, again, we can redo these simpler problems or little bit different type of problems. With that, I close dimensional analysis. Thank you so much.